Every time something goes wrong with the prison, I find...
Wait a minute. If we're going to start talking shop, I'm off.
Joe.
No, I'm definitely going to go into the kitchen. Do you like this?
Very nice.
Trouble. Joyce is on her way to the kitchen.
Oh, and the tea towel.
Mr. Barry.
Excuse me. I'd better check out.
Hello, Joe.
Claire. Hi.
I'm just going out for refill. You all right?
Yes, I'll stay with this, thank you.
Oh, what the hell. I'll have the same and a twist of lemon. Thanks.
Nice turnip.
Yep, nice. Oh, I'll get that. Anne's probably busy.
I'll get it.
Sorry. Did I hear the door?
Yes, Colleen's got it.
Oh, good. Everything all right? Can I get you anything?
No, I'm fine. Thank you.
I've been meaning to say thanks for coming, Joan. I know this sort of function isn't really your cup of tea.
I doubt I'd have been missed, if that's what you mean.
No, it's
he's
not.
Arrived at last.
Ah. Rick, where have you been?
Long story.
Everything all right?
Nothing a beer or tin won't fix.
Come on.
Hey, Joan.
Listen, if that we had in the
garden... Oh, hey, look out. She's not bad.
Oi.
Hi.
Reading up about babies, eh?
Yeah. It's the only one in the library. It's by some guy.
Oh, yeah? What would he know? Can I come in?
Of course.
Look, I know the last thing you probably want right now is me hanging around, but... Well, I just wanted to tell you how rotten I feel about everything.
It wasn't your fault.
Doesn't help you much, does it?
How's your wrists?
Oh, still there.
And the docs reckon that you're better and everything?
Oh, yeah, no worries. Yeah, I've had more tests than Greg Chappell. Bobby, if you'll give me another go, I'll be the best mate a person ever had. No kidding.
Suppose I'll have to, won't I? Kid's got to have an auntie from somewhere.
You mean that?
Said it, didn't I?
Well, suppose if I'm going to be an auntie, I better read up too. I have a gander after you.
Sure.
Ah, yeah. Oh, hey, there'll be no more of that.
What?
Fags. Bad for the baby.
Says who?
Says me. Two a day and no more. After all, if your mates won't back you up, not much point having them, is there?
So what more can I say? She's been a good friend and a pleasure to work with, and we'll all miss her.
To Colleen.
Colleen.
Good luck.
And I want you to accept this small, fairly small gift as a token of our appreciation and friendship.
Listen, thanks. I'm sorry.
Don't worry, you've still got some in your glass, or am I going to cop that too?
What?
It's typical of you, isn't it?
I don't believe this.
And I don't believe all of this. You've made your feelings perfectly clear. I won't impose on you any further.
I'm not bad, am I? Carl's turn sober.
Sorry, Pip, you mind if I sit there next to Bobby? Got us an extra tucker. There you go.
Oh, God. She's not going to eat all of that, Cass.
Bobby, you look clean.
Well, of course she does. She hasn't eaten anything proper yet. Dry toast won't do her no good. Now, you come on, you get that egg into you.
Remind me to stay right away from you when I've got a hangover.
Well, come on, Bobby, drink your milk. I'm going to ask Mrs. Reynolds to double it for you. Don't want the baby having soft bones.
Cass, I'm not having a bloody calf. Lay off, will you? I feel sick.
For your own good, but...
You're going to make a terrific father, Cass.
Might as well. She doesn't know who the real father is.
Phyllis, you shut your face and Bobby, don't you listen. Hey, can't wait till Dad and Albie. I'm going to be an auntie, eh?
Yeah. Oh, we're going to meet them all, aren't we? They are coming to the fete, aren't they?
Oh, I wouldn't miss it for the world. Pix.
What about Charlie?
Don't know if I'll ask him.
Oh, you have to, Cass. I mean, he's your beau.
Hey.
He's a what?
A boyfriend, isn't he, Cass?
Yeah, he's into pigs.
Oh. She's just jealous, love, because she hasn't got anyone.
Do your kids come in?
No.
Well,
Well, you know, it's a pity that Mrs. Powell won't be here, seeing it's her last day.
Oh, is it? Oh, we should have had a party for her and Hannah too.
I don't think Hannah would feel much like celebrating, love.
Yeah, well, I reckon we should celebrate. She should have been deported straight away.
It is a pity we can't deport you, Phyllis.
And Keane.
Yeah, to the morgue.
Oh, Bobby, that's a terrible thing to say.
Like, Helen. Oh, Cass, will you move those eggs? I'm going to be sick.
Well, it serves you right for saying such dreadful things.
Oh, why do we do it to ourselves?
I think it's the sleep that does it. I felt fine when I went to bed.
Good morning.
Good morning. Don't you all look dreadful?
Thanks.
Yeah.
If I'd known I was going to be this thirsty, I would have drunk more last night.
Well, can't put it off any longer.
Come along, Joyce. I'll hold your hand.
Right. Morning, Joan.
Morning, Joan.
Miss Ferguson. Joan, about last night. It was an accident.
Yeah, perhaps I overreacted a little.
No hard feelings.
Oh, I wouldn't go so far as to say that, but I can understand you not wanting to leave under a cloud.
Under a cloud? I was thinking of you.
Oh, I see. An old and trusted friend just wanting to clear the air, is that it?
Oh, how dare you.
You always did get excited easily, didn't you? Europe should suit you. Oh, and good luck.
Thank you. And how are you coping with Papa Cass?
I've had it, Jude. She won't let me do anything.
Oh, it's just her way of making up.
Yeah, I know. You haven't got a fag, have you?
Oh.
You don't smoke.
Got any juicy bits for the fortune-telling?
I thought of the perfect answer. Baby clothes.
Baby clothes? Why?
Easier. I just tell the women I hear the pitter-patter of little feet.
Pixie, you're a crook.
Why, Bobby, no! Jeez. Lifting heavy stuff's the worst thing you could be doing. How you feeling?
All right.
You know, I couldn't eat me brekkie this morning thinking you're feeling crook all by yourself in that cell.
Yeah.
Never again, but all fixed.
What?
I just been to see Mrs. Reynolds. Guess who your new cellmate is?
So, Hannah, we have found a relative and he's very enthusiastic about coming here. What is it? I thought you'd be happy.
I am very happy, but it's now too late.
Not if he gets here by 3 o'clock.
He's coming today? I may stay?
No. You must understand he cannot do anything at this stage. But he is prepared to raise money for your return.
Everyone so good to me. How may I thank you?
That's easy. Just keep fighting.
Miss Ferguson.
Oh, I think you'd better see this.
Huh. Camilla Wells, eh? More truth, justice, and the Australian way, I suppose.
Something like that.
Wentworth Prison is considering appointing as its deputy governor a woman of such callousness and such brutality that Hitler's Auschwitz will, by comparison, be reduced.